Just as a reference, this is locomotive is about 200 yards away from me at this point, in front of it. All three of those two bay hoppers out. Oh, hey, look who just showed up. Modelers taking back this tape up and look at the roofs of the first few cars here. They're totally covered in soot, but they're clean on the way back after that. Do a zoom in because there is an intermodal yard to the west of me off to the right, and they use a BNSF yard. You can just make these guys out, and these are remote controlled units. Looks like an SD40 with a long nose and a GP38 maybe. Anyways, they pull off empties from here and they run them east about a half mile to the yard. Let's zoom back out because our conductor's back on board, so I'm guessing they're done for the day. I'm going to be grabbing something because all three tracks over here have something on them, I think. Well, unfortunately, I have a very good angle, but if you look at the top of the shot, you'll see the remote units grabbing cars heading back over. Just above those remote units, you'll see an angled thing coming up. That's a concrete plant. The shot, you'll see some tanks in the background. That used to be Warum Chemical. I don't know who it is now. I know they do get tankers. Actually, you can see a few in the shot. Maybe I'll try to zoom in a little while. SF train, you know, shot and a lot of rep train going the other way. So yeah, if you guys want to come see action, Minnesota, Minneapolis, St. Paul, definitely have stuff running around. Finding good angles on it, it's a little hard sometimes. But, and actually, while I'm talking and we're looking at all this, between the auto rack and the background locomotive in the foreground, you're going to see another train come through. Unfortunately, we're just going to get a glimpse of it. Conductors walking around and coming to cab on a commercial. I'm going to try to hold the shot here. I won't see if we can get any look at what the train coming in is. Looks like tanker cars, so 50-50 chance it's ethanol or oil. So the train coming in the shot just above it, so they're going to come by us, same path the Amtrak took. So I'm going to pan out and we're going to walk sideways a little bit again and try to get an angle so we can get in the shot. TC&W. Another Minnesota commercial just showed up. This is T3, which if I remember it's a slug. And it is switched up to 88. Which I'd be guessing, but I think it's a 2300 horse unit. One cool thing about Minnesota Commercial is they used to have some really old stuff. I think now they're just down to the old stuff. I'm I'm going to walk a bit, so it's going to be a little shaky. Sorry, I'm going to try to get some rough details on the slug and mother bird. Anybody else in real fanning, you wonder what time of day it is. It's about 10 o'clock on a Saturday. It's actually Memorial Day weekend. Let's see if we can get some close-ups of the cables between these. This unit really interests me. I'm guessing it's a GP10, which were, remember these guys got the Iowa, or the Illinois Central rebuilds. A couple of neat things on this is the one's almost past the last radiator pan. It's got the extended stacks, it's got the paper, yeah, it's got the paper air filters. So these probably are the old Illinois Central GP10 rebuilds. You can see where they blanked out the headlight, put it up on top of the cab instead. Let's see. That's not the cab. Let's come back up. This is 2301. You guys love your roof details. It's going to give you a little closer shot.
the slug unit switching and 44 just sitting up there on the tracks. I don't think he's going anywhere. Not anytime soon. Guys, no stuff hanging on the front. So this still has his marker light boxes there. Stopping for a second, so I think they gotta wait for the slug to go. While I'm here, bottom of the shot, that brick building, that's a scale house, and you can see here, you can see the details in the scales.